वंदे गुरु श्री चरणारविंदम।
डोंट वरी, it's only a mild case of blood dysentery. Take the medicine and you'll be all right by tomorrow. Take this prescription to Mr. Day and he will give you the medicine.
Thank you, Dr. Ghosh.
Who is next? Come in.
This medicine should be taken 3 times daily after meals.
How much do they cost?
6.5 annas. Put this in. You check the ledger.
Okay.
All right.
It's a pity that so far we have not found anyone to help us.
Don't worry. Have faith in Krishna.
Maharaj, I think this is it.
Prayag Pharmacy, sole selling agent for Bose Laboratories, proprietor Abhay Charande. Yes, this is it. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Can I see Mr. Abhay Charande?
Just a minute. I'll go and tell him.
All right.
Abhay Babu, some sadhus are here to see you.
They must have come for treatment.
No, they specifically want to see you. Please come. Come in.
Gaudiya Vaishnavas.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
We came from Calcutta Gaudiya Mot.
Gaudiya Mot?
Yes.
You came from Gaudiya Mot? Then you must be disciples of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj.
Actually, I am a disciple of Sri Bhakti Vinod Thakur.
Oh, you are disciple of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur?
Yes, and my sannyasa guru is Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj. My name is Bhakti Pradeep Tirtha Goswami. This is Atul Nanda Das Brahmachari.
Hare Krishna.
And this is Madhav Das Brahmachari.
Hare Krishna.
We have come here to establish a temple and... As you are one of the most prominent Bengali businessmen in the city, we thought you may be able to help us.
A temple in Allahabad? Of course I'll help you. But tell me, where is Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj now?
He's in Madras at the moment. But how did you get to know him?
A friend took me to his ashram in Ultodanga Main Road about 5 years ago. Since then, I have accepted him as my most worshipable spiritual master.
You are his disciple.
Well, I haven't been formally initiated yet, but in my heart, I have accepted him as my spiritual master.
That is the most important consideration in the guru-disciple relationship. Therefore, you are his disciple.
I hope someday he will accept me.
Definitely.
Can you please come to my house this evening for prasad? We are pure vegetarians. We offer everything to Krishna.
Yes, I don't have any doubt about that. I was only wondering about some appointments that I have this evening. Anyway, I can postpone them.
Please do that. I'll give you my address.
All right.
Or should I send someone to collect you?
No, it won't be necessary. Allahabad is a small place. It won't be so difficult to find if you give me your address.
Yes. It's in Badshahi Mandi.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Abhay Babu, you're closing early today.
Yes. I have invited some important guests to my house tonight.
Who are they?
Some sadhus from Calcutta.
They must have come here to attend the Kumbh Mela.
No. They came to establish a temple here.
Ah, that would be nice. At least they have come here to stay. Abhay Babu, I like to associate with sadhus. But during Kumbh Mela, it becomes so noisy and crowded that I feel like leaving.
Kumbh Mela is a very special occasion. One can derive inconceivable piety by participating in it. That is why so many people come here to take part. Even the demigods come from higher planets.
Even the demigods come?
Yes.
Can one see them?
Actually, one needs special vision to see them. And besides that, they come disguised as human beings. That is why one cannot identify them.
Abhay Babu, you know so much. Where did you get all this knowledge?
My father is a very pious person. And he trained me from my childhood to appreciate spiritual culture.
The value of proper spiritual upbringing can never be underestimated. I can see that in you.
But you see, the actual spiritual upbringing depends upon...
Again. Shobha, can't you take care of him?
He was jumping on the bed and when I stopped him, he started crying.
Prayag, you're very naughty. When will you learn to behave yourself? Just wait till your father comes home today. I'll tell him what a difficult boy you've become. Okay, calm down.
Arey, what's happening here?
Just see, Prayag has become so difficult.
Oh.
Just go and take care of the sabji.
So, Prayagraj, what were you doing? Huh? Good boy. Today I invited some sadhus to take prasad.
How many of them?
One sannyasi and two brahmacharis. They are disciples of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj.
Where did you meet them?
They came to the pharmacy today. They are here to open a temple. I asked them to come at 7 o'clock. Will you be able to prepare some prasad for them?
I have plenty of time. But just send Bihari to get some sweets.
Yes. And we have to get some garlands also.
Right.
I'll get ready.
Okay.
Take him. Radharani, did Bihari get the garlands?
Yes, they're kept in the temple room.
And water for bathing Maharaj's feet?
Oh, I'll just get it.
Babu, the sadhus have arrived.
Maharaj. Please come in. Today my house is blessed.
Actually, it is my good fortune that I am getting your association.
Please come.
The deities are so beautiful. It must be due to your devotion, Abhay Babu.
Thank you, Maharaj. Please bless me that I may always serve the Lord and His devotees nicely. Lord Krishna is always very pleased with one who serves and honors His devotees properly. Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Please come. Please.
Hare Krishna. Krishna. What's that for?
I want to bathe your lotus feet, Maharaj.
No, Abhay Babu. I can't allow that.
Please, Maharaj. It's my duty as a householder. I'm so fortunate to have such an exalted devotee like yourself in my home. Please. Please allow me to bathe your lotus feet, Maharaj.
Babu, you are embarrassing me.
A personality like yourself purifies even the holy places of pilgrimage. When a householder like me is blessed with the good fortune to meet a saintly devotee like yourself, he must take full advantage of it.
I am just an ordinary man, struggling to attain the spiritual platform.
Maharaj, please bless us with your words of wisdom.
All I can do is simply glorify the Lord by chanting his holy name.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,
some more paish, Maharaj.
No, I can't. I've taken too much already.
Please?
No, enough. Thank you.
Maharaj, please tell us more about Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj's activities.
Recently, he has opened centers in Puri, Dhaka and Madras. He also established printing presses in Calcutta and Mayapur to print a daily newspaper in Bengali called Nodia Prakash. And a year ago, he began publishing a magazine called Sajjana Toshani, which is printed in 3 languages, including an English-selling edition called The Harmonist. Besides that, Srila Prabhupada has completed commentaries on Srimad Bhagavatam and Chaitanya Charitamrita. Recently, he led over 500 devotees on a parikrama of Sri Navadvip Dham.
And it was by the endeavors of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur that the true birthplace of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was established in Mayapur. In order to gain monetary profit, many unscrupulous people still try to deceive the innocent public by claiming that the Lord's birthplace is in this place, which is one of the 9 islands of Navadvip called Koladvip. These people are so engrossed in material activities that they do not care about the consequences of their actions. They are only concerned with immediate profit in order to have some flickering sense pleasure based on money and women. Therefore, they do not hesitate to indulge in the most heinous sinful activities. Real happiness is experienced only when one does not deviate from truth. What is the point of lying about the birthplace of the Supreme Personality of Godhead just to earn a few rupees?
Did you hear how he is blaspheming us?
The actual birthplace of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Antardvip. Their claims are futile and cannot be substantiated by any scriptural evidence.
He will have to pay a heavy price for his offenses. He is the one.
Attack!
Prabhupada, we have to go. Please. गुरु महाराज, विनोद प्रभु,
प्रभुपाद, प्लीज लेट्स गो,
यू टेक केयर ऑफ हिम।
देयर ही गोस, गेट हिम।
What are you doing, Vinod?
Please, Prabhupada, we must exchange clothes. You're their main target.
Why, Vinod? Why? Why do we have to exchange clothes?
So that I can divert them away from you, Prabhupada.
So you want me to run away like a coward?
Please, Prabhupada, I know you are not afraid, but it's my duty to protect my spiritual master.
Look, there he goes.
Come on, come on. Get him!
These people stoop so low as to attack a Paramhams?
You must understand. These swindlers run a business in the name of religion, and therefore Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati set out to preach the truth and expose them. And it is quite natural that they will react so heinously.
But still I...
Srila Prabhupada told us not to worry about all these unpleasant happenings. They will only enhance our devotion to Krishna.
Srila Prabhupada?
Yes, that is the name by which the devotees refer to our Gurudev, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. It means one at whose lotus feet all other masters sit.
It's undoubtedly the most perfect way to address him, Maharaj.
Thousands of people are following him.
And many more will.
He does not compromise. He mercilessly attacks anything that is opposed to pure devotional service. That's why he's also become known as Simha Guru.
He's certainly a lion-like personality.
Is the doctor in?
No, Dr. Ghosh hasn't arrived yet. He comes at about 9 o'clock. Please be seated. He'll be here soon.
But my son is very ill. He's vomiting and passing stool. Some people are saying these are symptoms of cholera. Please tell me, what should I do now?
Then you should immediately get him treated. Vanmali? Vanmali?
Yes, sir?
Please take this gentleman to Dr. Ghosh's house as quickly as you can.
All right.
I'm sure he'll still be there.
Abhay Babu, it seems that the city is being attacked by an epidemic of cholera. I heard that 28 people died yesterday.
Yes.
And everyone is talking about more and more of such cases. It's very worrying. Because there is no cure for it. What to do?
Actually, there is nothing we can do, apart from taking shelter of the Lord.
You mean just by praying to the Lord one can become cured?
Praying does not guarantee a cure. But even one is not, Krishna will take care of him. Actually, this material body is perishable. We are all going to die one day. But when we surrender to Krishna, then he will deliver us. That's what really matters. We are all subject to karma. If we act sinfully, we will suffer. But if we surrender to the Lord's lotus feet, our sins will be absolved.
It's a great pity that we are losing our spiritual culture and people are turning away from God.
Yes. A great pity. People need to be educated. When I was young, I contracted typhoid. At that time, there was no cure for it. My father simply prayed and gave me Charanamrita from the Lord's lotus feet. By the Lord's mercy, I was saved.
Mm-hmm.
another occasion, there was an epidemic of cholera in Calcutta. Some sadhus organized a massive chanting of the holy name of the Lord, and the epidemic was averted.
But the skeptics will say it was not due to the prayers, but some other cause.
Yes. What a madman will not say, and what a goat will not eat.
You came back so early today.
Yes. I have to go to Saharanpur for a few days. Can you please pack up my things? And where are the children?
They've gone out with Baba for a walk.
Hmm.
How many days will you be gone for?
Maybe 8 or 10 days. I can't really say. My train is at 6 o'clock. So please pack up my things.
Okay.
I'll just take a bath.
Traveling so much nowadays, you hardly spend any time at home.
See, the business is going on and I have to visit so many customers.
The other day I overheard you telling Dr. Ghosh that the payments are not coming in regularly.
Yes, I have to give credit to the customers, but they are not paying in time. Still, I have to keep supplying them and the amount of credit is increasing. That's why I have to travel so many times. I have to chase them for payments. Otherwise, they're not going to pay.
When you started your own business, you thought that you will get free from material entanglements and have enough time to preach the message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Just see what happened.
Yes, the material nature is like that, Radharani. No matter how hard you try to free yourself, she has a way to tie you down. This for?
I'm packing these fruits for your traveling.
But it won't be necessary.
But when you're away from home, you hardly eat anything.
See, when I find a Vishnu temple, I take prasad. Otherwise, there is plenty of fruits, nuts and milk available in the market.
But why are you traveling so much and working so hard?
I'm working so hard because I have to earn enough to spread the glorious teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and still have enough to maintain you all. I don't want to become a rich man.
Nice to see you.
I'm also happy to see you.
But why didn't you inform us that you were coming?
I had to come all of a sudden.
Well, the room on the roof where you like to stay has already been booked.
That doesn't matter. Give me any room that's available. Oh.
Well, room number 7 on the first floor is a very nice one.
That will be fine with me.
Sign, please. Here you are.
Thank you.
Ramu, oh Ramu.
Yes, Babu.
Take Abhay Babu to room number 7. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Ram Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram.
Birju!
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
Birju Prasad!
Yes, Babu! I'm coming!
You lit the fire so early in the morning. Do you think coal comes free?
I didn't light the fire, Babu.
Then where did he get hot water from? Does hot water rain from sky nowadays?
I'm telling you, Babu. I didn't light the fire.
Then how did the gentleman in room 7 get hot water?
Oh, you mean that medicine, Babu? Whenever he comes here, he takes his bath very early in the morning, and that too with cold water, even in winter.
What? He takes bath in cold water? The thought just makes my bones shiver. I thought I saw his body steaming.
He's not an ordinary man, Babu. He must be a Siddha Yogi. He bathes and he daily does his puja. And he sings so beautifully. When I listen to his singing very early in the morning, I feel as if I have been transported to another world. Listen, Babu.
Jaya Jaya Madhava Madana Murari Radhe Shyam Shyama Shyam. Jaya Jaya Keshava Kali Malhari Radhe Shyam Shyama Shyam. Radhe Shyam Shyama Shyam. Sundar Kundal Madhura Vishala Gale Sohe Vaijayanti Mala Yachavi Ki Balihari. लूट लूट दधिखायो कब हो मधुवन रास रचायो नाचत विपिन बिहारी नाचत विपिन बिहारी Radhe Shyam Shyam Shyam. Bal bal sang dhenu charai ban ban bhramat phire jagurai kaadhe kamar kari kaadhe kamar kari. Radhe Shyam Shyam Shyam.
Radhe Shyam Shyam Shyam.
असुरा नवनीत जुखायो चुरा चुरा नवनीत जुखायो रजवनितन पे नाम धरायो माखन चोर मुरारी माखन चोर मुरारी राधे श्याम 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 एक दीन मान इंद्र कुमारयो नख ऊपर गोवर्धन धारयो नाम पढ़यो गिरधारी नाम पढ़यो गिरधारी राधे श्याम श्याम
How nice to see you again. Please take a seat. Can I offer you some tea, please?
You know that I don't drink tea.
Oh, I completely forgot. Tiwari?
Yes, sir.
Can you please come here? Please take an order of 2 cases of ointment and...
Mr. Agarwal. I won't be able to supply you unless you clear your old debts.
But, Abhay Babu, the market is very bad and the business is so dull.
If business is so dull, then why do you want new supplies?
You see, I have given the medicine on credit. And if people pay me, then I'll pay you back.
I have been hearing this from you for months. How can you expect me to supply if you don't pay?
Abhay Babu, I guarantee you, I will pay you next month. This time I will not fail.
Mr. Agarwal, you see, I have been gifted with one talent. I can see through a person. You think you are fooling me? But actually you are fooling yourself. Just to accumulate a few rupees, you don't hesitate to lie. But did you ever consider what a heavy price you'll have to pay for that?
You are cursing me.
No, I'm not cursing you. I'm forecasting the inevitable and trying to warn you for your own benefit.
If you speak like this, then I'll call the police.
Actually, it is I who should call the police and take you to the court for not paying me. But I won't, because I don't want to stoop so low just to get some money out of you. If you think by cheating me you will gain, then go ahead and cheat me.
Tiwari?
Yes, sir.
Give me the accounts book. Abhay Babu, I'm so sorry that I did not deal with you honestly.
That's all right.
Today, you opened my eyes and made me realize that accumulating money is not the only goal of life. Please forgive me. I'll settle all the outstanding debts right now. Here, take this money.
Thank you.
Anurag, did you finish your homework?
Yes, ma.
I received a letter from Madhavi today.
Oh, I see. What did she say? Are they all right?
Yes, everything is fine. Besides Baba's health, Dada started a new business. And they found a suitable boy for Jayanti. Prayag! Prayag! What are you doing? Don't touch the fan. Sit here.
Why is he crying?
He's become so naughty. He wants to touch the fan. We have to always let him do whatever he wants.
I want to touch it too.
So you want to touch the fan?
Yes.
But do you know what will happen if you touch it? You'll hurt yourself.
No, I want to touch it. I want to touch it.
Prayag, try to understand what your father is saying. If you touch the fan, you will cut your finger.
No, I want to touch the fan.
Very well. Prayagraj, come here. Now here is the fan. Touch it. What happened?
I hurt my finger.
That's what I told you. But you would not listen. You see, some people learn by hearing, some by seeing, and some by getting hurt. So you fall in the third category. I hope you learnt your lesson. Why don't you go and touch it again?
No, I won't touch it. No, I won't touch the fan.
The potential of the Indian market is very good. The person we decide on should be fully dedicated to market our products.
Hello, Mr. De. Please have a seat. They are expecting you.
Thank you.
Mr. Johnson, do you think Mr. De is the right person?
Yes. Not only does he have many years of experience in this field, he's also very honest.
Do we have to appoint an Indian agent? Can't we get a reputed British firm to represent us?
Bradley, if we wish to distribute our products in the interior of this country, we need Indian agents to do that.
Sir, Mr. Day is here to see you.
Okay, ask him to come in.
All right.
This is our third meeting with him. I think today we should give him an answer.
Do you think he is competent to market our products?
Yes, Lindsay. He has 15 years of experience in marketing pharmaceutical products.
But I am concerned that he does not have a good financial standing.
That's true. But we're not looking for a stockist. We're looking for a marketing manager. We're not going to stock our products with him.
But isn't it preferable to have a solvent agent rather than a person who doesn't have much financial credibility?
I personally think what we need is an honest man with experience. And to tell you frankly, of all the people we've seen, he seems to be the best choice.
Mr. Sharma, what do you think?
I've already voiced my reservations about his credibility.
But don't forget, he was the top agent for Bosch Laboratories.
Lindsay, I admire your progressive attitude and revolutionary ideas, but I do not always agree with you. Gentlemen, I have a meeting to attend, so you'll carry on. Please let me know what you have decided upon.
Goodbye, Bradley.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, sir.
Good day.
Good day, Mr. Day.
Good afternoon.
Please come and take a seat.
Yes, thank you.
Please bring a cup of tea for Mr. Day.
No, that won't be necessary, sir. I don't drink tea.
How strange. When the whole world drinks the elixir from India, you don't? You know it is very good for your constitution.
I don't drink tea because it is an intoxicant.
Intoxicant? Why?
Because it has caffeine, which has an intoxicating effect.
Oh, I see. Anyway.
So, Mr. Day, it appears that you have a lot of experience in marketing pharmaceutical products since you were the sole selling agent for Bose Laboratories in Northern India.
Yes, since 1923.
You see, we're looking for somebody who will be very dedicated and enthusiastic to distribute our products in this part of India.
I'll try my best.
What is your establishment like?
Well, I don't really have much of an establishment now, but I can set it up. I'm manufacturing and marketing my own pharmaceutical products.
Oh, I see. So simultaneously, you want to run two businesses?
If I take the agency for your product, I'm not going to manufacture mine. I will honestly admit that my business is not doing very well. That's why I'm considering your offer.
That's very good to know, Mr. Day. It's 5 o'clock. Why don't we go to the club and continue our discussion there? Is that all right with you, Mr. Day?
As a matter of fact, I go to the temple every evening to attend the service at 6 o'clock.
I'm sure you can make an exception on a day like this. After all, we are going to discuss some very important business. Do you have a problem today?
Yes, if you don't mind, sir. I'd like to be excused. Maybe we could continue the discussion tomorrow.
Is it so important that you go to the temple?
Yes. It means a lot to me.
No, not now.
Thank you very much.
Obviously, he's not the man we want.
Oh, जय विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शत श्री श्रीमद श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर श्रील प्रभुपाद की श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती ठाकुर प्रभुपाद की।
अभय बाबू, श्रीधर महाराज हैज गॉन आउट फॉर अ प्रोग्राम दिस इवनिंग। He asked me to request you to give the Bhagavad Gita class.
Me? No, no, I can't give a class. Actually, you should take the class.
No, Abhay Babu. Everyone loves to hear your classes. And besides that, Sridhar Maharaj specifically requested that you give the class.
You see, I'm just a neophyte devotee. And on top of that, I'm a householder. You are so much more advanced than me. So you should give the class.
Please don't speak like that, Abhay Babu. Everyone can see how advanced you are.
Bihari, Gopi Jana Vallabha, Girivar Dhari.
Gopi Jana Vallabha, Girivar Dhari.
Gopi Jana Vallabha, Girivar Dhari.
Gopi Jana Vallabha.
You don't have to thank me.
You are a very noble soul.
Please sit.
Where are you going?
I'm going to Delhi.
Acha. Do you live in Delhi?
No. I live in Prayag. Going to Delhi on business.
Oh, what is your business?
I sell pharmaceutical products, medicines.
Do you manufacture them yourself?
No. I'm the selling agent of the manufacturers in Calcutta.
Hey, chai wala. Two cups, please.
No, I don't drink tea.
You don't drink tea? Why?
Because it affects your consciousness.
Well, then I can't take it either. Go. Go, go.
Thank you. I have some fruits. Would you like to have some?
Yes. Thank you. Acha, how many children do you have?
Three. Two sons and one daughter.
Nice. I can see that you are a Vaishnav.
I'm trying to become a devotee of the Lord. By the way, where are you going?
Virat.
Virat?
Yes. I am also a Vaishnav.
I am very happy to meet you.
Thank you.
यस्या गया भ्रमति संभ्रत कालचक्र गोविंदम अधिपुरुषम तमहम भजामि।
ओह, इट्स मथुरा।
It was a pleasure meeting you. I hope to see you again sometime.
What happened? You told me you were going to Delhi, but this is Mathura.
Yes, I changed my mind.
Oh,
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Excuse me, please.
Can I help you?
Can you tell me where can I find Bhakti Pradeep Tirth Maharaj?
Arre, Abhay Babu. What a pleasant surprise. Welcome, Abhay Babu, to the Brajamandal Parikrama. When did you come?
Just now. Thank you very much. You're always so kind towards me.
Why didn't you inform us that you were coming? We could have sent someone to the station to pick you up.
Actually, I was on my way to Delhi. But when the train stopped at Mathura station, I just got down and came here.
Only you can do such a thing, Abhay Babu. Come, I will arrange a place for you to stay.
Maharaj, don't worry about me. I'll find some place.
No. You are a very special guest, and it is our duty to take care of you. After you take your bath in Prasad, I will take you to Srila Prabhupada. He will be very pleased to see you.
Oh, can I see him now?
Your eagerness compels me to comply to your request.
Dasosmi. I'm your servant.
Srila Prabhupada, this is Abhay Babu from Allahabad.
Yes, I know him. I'm happy to see you, Abhay. You must be tired. Go take your bath and prasad. We will talk later.
Srila Prabhupada has appeared for this purpose, Abhay Babu. He is personally organizing and leading the preaching. He's establishing centers all over and printing and distributing spiritual literature.
Very good.
He is engaging everyone in the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
How noble.
You are so involved with the Allahabad Center, Abhay Babu. You are ready to offer all help to the devotees there. Abhay Babu, please sit down. Give me a bucket. Let me serve.
No, Maharaj. I can't let you do that.
No. It is my privilege.
But Maharaj, you are embarrassing me. You are a sannyasi. Actually, I should serve you.
You are our honored guest. And besides that, the opportunity to serve a devotee like yourself is extremely rare.
But I am not a devotee. And I am not even initiated.
Maharaj, both of you sit down. Let us serve.
A devotee's love for the Lord does not really depend on the external formalities. It is the purity of the heart that manifests in the form of attachment to the Lord.
Tirth Maharaj, I have been told that a pure devotee considers everyone else to be a devotee. And I can see it in your behavior.
You know, Abhay Babu, when I took you to Srila Prabhupada,
The way he said, "Yes, I know him," gave me the impression that your relationship with him is not only of this lifetime, but from the past. How is your father, Abhay Babu?
He passed away last winter.
Oh, he was such a nice person.
He left his body very peacefully. Just before leaving his body, he asked me to donate the cow to the temple and feed all the devotees. Then he left the body, chanting the name of Krishna.
Fortunate soul. I wish I could leave my body in that way.
Krishna's Shakti is manifested as Shri Bhu and Neela. The Neela Shakti is the Dham of Krishna. Although, through our mundane eyes, Vrindavan appears to be a place made of atoms and molecules. Actually, it is the transcendental abode of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This land here is Chintamani, that stone. The water is not water but nectar, and the trees are not trees but desire trees. Where were you all this while?
Srila Prabhupada, we went to see the deities in the local temples over here.
Going to see the deities instead of listening to the Bhagavatam class given by your spiritual master is nothing but a waste of time. At most, it is some sort of exercise for your eyes. You will never be able to see the spiritual form of the Supreme Personality of Godhead with your mundane eyes. It is through one's ears that one can see him. Therefore, this process is called Srotapanta. As you hear, your heart becomes purified and your consciousness becomes spiritualized. Then your spiritual senses awaken and you can perceive the spiritual form of the Lord. Transcendental reality is not perceivable through the material senses. Therefore, I repeatedly remind you, hear attentively, open your ears that you may see clearly.
When I saw you for the first time 10 years ago, you opened my darkened eyes and filled my heart with transcendental knowledge. From that time, I accepted you as my spiritual master. You asked me to preach the message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu throughout the world. But 10 precious years have gone by and I have not been able to do anything. I am so useless. Please tell me what to do. How can I serve you?
Don't worry, Abhay Charan. In due course of time, Krishna will make you achieve all kinds of wonderful things for him.
It's only due to your mercy, Srila Prabhupada, that I am able to do whatever little I am doing.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Sankirtan movement will spread all over the world, in every town and village. Dedicate yourself completely to accomplish that mission. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will bestow his mercy upon you.
Srila Prabhupada, will you kindly deliver me from this miserable material world by accepting me as your disciple?
Yes. I've already decided to give you initiation on the next Purnima in Allahabad. Go take rest now. You must be tired. What is the need of many stars when there is one moon in the sky? Why don't you propagate the teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu?
I have found the goal of my life. From today, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur is my spiritual master.
Don't worry, Abhay Charan. In due course of time, Krishna will make you achieve all kinds of wonderful things for him. All living things, not just human, are servants of Lord Krishna. Hear attentively, open your eyes that you may see clearly. The preaching of Krishna Bhakti is so important that it cannot wait for anything. Go spread the message all over the world. This is our primary duty. Yes, I know him. I am happy to see you, Abhay.
Did you call me?
Yes. You know, Radha, Srila Prabhupada has decided to give me initiation.
Achha? That's very nice. You have been waiting for such a long time.
Yes. Generally, it is the custom that husband and wife take initiation together. What happened?
I don't know. I really don't know.
Why?
I don't think I'm ready for initiation.
Radha, there is nothing to be afraid of.
Initiation is a serious matter. It requires commitment.
Yes, and this commitment is essential for spiritual advancement. Look, Radha, you are already performing deity worship. All you need to do now is increase your devotion a little.
It is not increasing devotion that I'm afraid of. It's what I have to give up.
We have never indulged in sinful activities like meat eating, gambling, illicit sex, or intoxication. What is there to give up?
What about tea?
Radha, you have to give it up.
Why do I have to give it up?
Because tea is an intoxicant.
Why? Everyone drinks tea. One does not get drunk by drinking tea.
Tea may not be strong, but still, it's an intoxicant. See how you become so addicted to it? Isn't it proof enough? You see, Srila Prabhupada is a pure devotee. Therefore, whatever standards he has set must be followed for our own benefit.
As it is, I rarely see you. If you're not traveling on business, you're at the mat till late, singing bhajans and ringing the bells.
To sing the glories of the Lord and associate with his devotees is the ultimate goal of life. That's why I've always been trying to persuade you to help me.
Yes, and I'll continue to help you. But I'm not ready for initiation.
Do you know what receiving initiation from a pure devotee means? It means freedom from material bondage. It means opening of the door to the spiritual sky.
The commitment of initiation is too difficult to fulfill. I have other duties to take care of.
The goal of the life is to become a pure devotee of the Lord. That is your most important duty. Everything else is secondary.
You take initiation. Start your spiritual life. I have my household affairs to take care of.
Why are you becoming so stubborn, Radha? Why? Why can't you help me build a home with Krishna in the center?
I have done everything that I could have for our family. But what have you done? All we get from you is neglect.
Did you ever consider why? Because you are not inclined to join me in spiritual life. Anyway, I won't push you any longer. Do as you wish. His name is Devatlal, a very pious man. I've known him for many years, but I've never approached him for a donation before.
You see, Krishna does not accept the offering from everyone or anyone because he feels indebted when he accepts something from someone. Come.
We have come to see Sid Devatlal ji. Is he in?
Yes. Please come in. Please be seated.
Hare Krishna.
हरे कृष्णा।
नमस्कार।
हाउ आर यू?
फाइन।
प्लीज कम इनसाइड। थ्रू हियर प्लीज टेक अ सीट।
I have brought some very distinguished personalities to your home today.
This is my good fortune, Abhay Babu. Tirthi Kurvati Tirthani, Savant Asthana Gadha Bruja. Saintly persons like you sanctify even the places of pilgrimage.
Said Devatlal ji, it is a true saint who always carries the Lord in his heart. I am just an ordinary person trying to become a devotee of the Lord. But from your words, I see that you are a very learned devotee.
Oh, no, no. I'm not at all learned. Nor am I a devotee. I'm an ordinary businessman. My whole life revolves around money. And my obsession is how to multiply it. And besides that, I'm just rotting in this household life.
Actually, household life is also an ashram called Rashta Ashram, where one can cultivate his spiritual life. There are so many exemplary devotees of the Lord who were in the household ashram. Our spiritual master's father was not only a householder, he was also a high-ranking officer in the British government. And here in front of us is another householder devotee.
Do you have to embarrass me in public, Maharaj? Sripad Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj is one of the first sannyasi disciple of our spiritual master, about whom I have told you before. And Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Maharaj is helping our establishment in Bombay. Now he has come here to establish a temple of Sri Sri Radha Krishna in Prayag.
That is very good news.
I have brought them to you to request a donation for the construction of the temple.
Abhay Babu, I will positively help you, but I have to think about it.
Devatlal ji, what is there to think about?
I have to think about the amount.
There's no need to think about donating to the Lord. Devatlal ji, he has given you so much. Therefore, it is your duty to express your gratitude by offering a part of your possessions to him.
Yes, I know. That is why I give in charity. There are so many religious organizations. They all come to me. But you see, I have my limitations. Ah, let me. Please. Here. Abhay Babu?
No, thank you. But Seth ji, this temple is going to be built just once. It's not that we are going to come to you every day. I've known you for so many years. Have I ever asked you for any favor?
That's true, Abhay Babu, but...
No, there's no but. Just decide.
Theek hai, I'll give 10,000 rupees.
Bas? Just 10,000? 10,000 is not enough for a person of your stature. Okay, I'll make it easier for you. Make it at least 20,000.
Please send someone to collect it tomorrow.
All right. I'll come and collect it tomorrow. May we take your leave?
I'll see you tomorrow.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Do remember me again when you need any help.
Sure.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
He's such a nice and generous person.
Yes. But the more I get to see Abhay, the more impressed I get. You are so expert in whatever you do.
Yes, as you have said, Sekh ji is definitely a very generous man. Yes, indeed.
Oh.
मित्रः सम्मरुणः सं नो भवत् अर्यमा सं नयेन्द्रो बृहस्पतिः सं नो विष्णुरुक्रमा नमो ब्रह्मणे नमस्ते वायुर्त्वमेव
ललिता श्रीविशाखपितांश्च स्वाहा पञ्चकल्पतरोभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धोभ्येव च पतितानां भावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः स्वाहा नम ओं विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिसिद्धान्त सरस्वतीति नामिने स्वाहा
Your name is Abhay Charan Aravind Das. That means a servant who is fearless.
Om Sat Savitur Rain.